Hello dear learners, today we will be discussing on our chapter which is heat. Do you all know what heat is all about? Yes, heat is an invisible form of energy and also not only a form of energy but also it gives us a sensation of hotness and coldness. So our objective of today will be, we will be discussing on heat, temperature, clinical and laboratory thermometer. We will be discussing on the difference between heat and temperature. And also we will be discussing on various type of temperature scales. So, why do we wear different type of clothes in winter and summer? Yes, we wear different type of clothes in winter and summer because in winters, it is usually cold. So, we prefer to wear more clothes so to keep us warm. While in summers, it is already warm. So, we prefer to wear cotton clothes. How do we check if something is hot or cold? We often tell something is hot or cold by the sense of touch. But can we rely on the sense of touch to find if something is hot or cold? Let's do an activity. Dip your hands into the jar having different types of water. Jar 1 will contain hot water, jar B will contain cold water, and jar C will contain lukewarm water. Means you have to take 3 types of jars which are filled with 3 different types of water. And then you have to see what happens. One of the hands will feel that the water is hot, while the other hand will feel that the water is cold. So why does this happen? So this happens because of the difference in the temperature of water. Temperature? What is temperature now? So this means we cannot rely on our hands to find if something is hot and cold. Then how can we find how hot an object is? A reliable measure of hotness or coldness of an object is its temperature. So, what is temperature? Temperature is the measure of the heat in the body. It identifies a body as hot or cold. And the SI unit in which we measure temperature is denoted as Kelvin. And Kelvin is usually denoted by capital letter K. The instrument which is used for measuring temperature is called thermometer. Yes. And the thermometer is an instrument for measuring and indicating temperature. So kids, now we will be discussing on different types of thermometer. So we are having 2 types of thermometer here. One is clinical thermometer and another is the laboratory thermometer. The thermometer which is being displayed on your screen currently is the clinical thermometer. And now, the thermometer which is being displayed on your screen on the right hand side is the laboratory thermometer. Do you know what clinical thermometer is? Yes, the thermometer which we use in our homes. The thermometer which we use in clinic. Right, the doctor uses in its clinic. Yes. That is why it is called clinical thermometer, correct. The thermometer that is used to measure our body temperature is called clinical thermometer. And also, what you can see in the thermometer, we have a long narrow glass tube. And also it is filled with a shiny silvery liquid, which is called mercury. And do you know what is the range of clinical thermometer? Yes, the clinical thermometer ranges the temperature from 35 degrees centigrade to 42 degrees centigrade. Can you see a kink over the thermometer? Yes, this kink in the thermometer, what is this kink in the thermometer? This kink in the thermometer, actually, as soon as you take the temperature from the thermometer, this kink doesn't allow the temperature to fall back readily. Means, you can easily read the temperature in the thermometer after you have taken the temperature from your body. So this kink doesn't allow the mercury to fall back again. It helps you to take the temperature accurately and correctly. Now what is laboratory thermometer? It is comparatively longer than a clinical thermometer, yes. And it is mainly used in laboratories to measure temperature with high accuracy. So now let's discuss. When we inserted our hand in the jar having hot water, our hand was inflamed, right? So why did this happen? This is because of heat transfer. Because of heat transfer, our hand felt hot. So How did this heat transfer occur? Yes, this heat transfer occurred because the hot object, which was the water, the heat transferred from the hot water to the hands, and our hand was a cold object. So usually heat transfers from the hotter body to a colder body. Correct. Now, can you see some pictures displayed on your screen? And please, can you tell me? Can you tell me which objects are hot and which objects are cold? Yes, ice cream is a cold object. Tea is a hot object. Pizza is a hot object. And juice is a cold object. Correct. So, do you have any idea about heat? What heat is? Yes, heat is a form of energy and it can neither be created nor it can be destroyed, but only it can be converted to other forms of energy. For example, in motorized vehicles, you can see, right? Heat energy is converted to mechanical energy. Correct. So in electric bulbs, it is converted to light energy, and in thermal power plants, it is finally converted to electrical energy. Yes.